Namaskar to all the elders, eminent personalities, Swamiji, domain experts, Sangha Adhikaris. I am not going by name just to reduce the time taken. But all of you, I have my greetings on Dasara Day and also Sadar Pranam to all of you for agreeing to be present for this meeting. It is a moment of pride to Sanskriti Foundation to have come to this stage. For the last over 10 years, Sanskriti Foundation has been trying to create awareness, propagate culture among various sections of the society. Two milestone events already mentioned by Mr. Raju in his introductory remarks, one in 2015, another in 2018, have to some extent redefined and refined the activities to be carried out by Sanskriti Foundation. As a result of that, the profile of the activity have been redefined, and as a result of that, today we have a big initiative in the name of Sanskriti Adhyayana Kendra, which will focus on recapturing our past glory and trying to connect it to the present governing systems of the country, both in the government and also in the private. I am tempted to remind what Pujya Sansanchalak ji has said in the morning Baudhik today, that in the post-COVID, the near normal which is being talked about by the experts has a large number of glimpses of our cultural past, our traditions, which need to be retained on a permanent basis. We have been echoing. This is a clarion call in a way to us of what we are trying to do, and he has also seemed to have given a direction. The initial impetus for this activity had come, as already mentioned by Mananiya Suresh Ji Soni Ji in June 2018, when he said, culture is the fifth dimension of our Bharat. Our decision should be based on our cultural ethos so that they have a largest acceptability among the nation and sustainability for the future. This has been the main broad contours under which we thought we should start redefining our activity. Then how do we do this activity? It is not an easy task. It's a tall order. So we thought in redefining it, we should restructure ourselves with eminent personalities and distinguished persons who have spent decades of their life in excelling in their respective professions, and request them to guide us, giving their knowledge and insights into this through the advisory council. Similarly, we have a galaxy of achievers in the governing council who have made a mark with and distinguished themselves in their careers to really guide the fortunes of the Sanskriti Foundation and the Adhyayana Kendra. Similarly, we have also a large number of foot soldiers in the executive committee who have been doing an eminent job, enormous job. It was not an easy task for us to have something like more than 1,000 eminent personalities of the Twin Cities to gather in two different meetings spanned by 3 years in between. It was a yeoman task, which is really a great challenge to us, but we seem to have succeeded with the blessings of all the seniors available here. Now, what we are trying to do is that we have a past which had a glory. We seem to have forgotten that. Atma Vismruti is what we term ourselves that. We have to rediscover ourselves and find our roots. They say, larger is the extent of the civilization, age of the civilization, deeper are its roots. I am reminded of my stay in BHEL when one of our seniors said, when we send our engineers for training abroad, that let them see not only what is above the ground, but what is below the ground. Depends on the age of the company, there would be deeper roots which are not visible to the outsiders, but they should probe for those roots and try to understand the actual aspects of how it's being governed. So we know that a country can be governed through its roots. Today we have a necessity and a requirement and a challenge that the world is facing, that we have to rediscover ourselves, our roots, and strengthen those roots. Basing on these deep roots and the foundations, we have to look for the future, to mold ourselves and the country in a fashion that is sustainable, in a manner that we will be able to find some sort of a guiding force for the world and to become slowly a Vishwaguru, which we have been aspiring to in this country. Towards this end, we have been trying to gather experts, connect with them. There are several of them who are working silently in their respective areas. They need to be given a helping hand. Their energies have to be channelized and directed towards preparing public policy frameworks so that this public policy framework could be processed properly with the government and also through the private sector also. Even private sector needs some such inputs. Like, for instance, we are talking of so-called corporate social responsibility is nothing but to take the society into account and try to make something contribute towards the society of whatever we are doing. So we can start redefining all these terminology in terms of our own ethos and try to give the inputs to the government so that there is a change of course in the decision-making processes. We have seen some such efforts have already been bearing fruit. We have seen some result in the formulation of the National Education Policy 2020 by the Government of India, wherein certain such inputs have come. Today, I was reading a magazine here, a special issue by Times of USA, which says that in the third trimester of a mother, pregnant mother, the child in the womb can understand the language. Now, today science is telling this. This country has told this thousands of years ago through Astavakra, through Abhimanyu, through several others, Prahlada and all that. So therefore, we have to find evidence for our beliefs, for our practices, show them, showcase them before the world so that the world also accepts and then our governing systems suitably incorporates them into the decision-making processes, which has a ring of actual, you know, connectivity with the common man. A common man understands a slogan from Mahabharata much better than anything else drawn from outside. Our own thinking has to be sort of, you know, India-centric. Now, this thinking, what Professor Kothari has said during the work in the Education Commission in the 1960s, that the intellectuals have to start thinking and should have their gravity in India rather than Western Europe. Now, that seems to be slowly happening in this country. And Sanskriti Adhyayana Kendra will focus on this activity of capturing the work of these eminent personalities working in their respective areas and trying to formulate an approach so that we work with the government. I'm happy also to share with you that AACTE has already started a wing, Indian Knowledge Systems, to coordinate this work. Thousands and thousands of small and big karyakartas and workers are working in this area. It's a task of magnitude, of Himalayan magnitude, but with the advice, with the depth, with the height of personalities that we have behind us, and also the support and the understanding of the dhikaris of Sangh, and also various other people in the society, we feel confident that we can make those baby steps to really move in the direction that we have been cherishing for several years. I conclude by these small remarks, and we await for the other elders who are present today to advise us, to guide us, to move forward in this area and in the future to come. Thank you. Thank you one all. Namaskar.
Thank you very much, sir, for that introductory remarks. I would request Padma Bhushan.
Namaskar ji. Dhanyavad to Anirudh ji and all other elders. Actually, at the end of this 1.5 hour session, I feel how small I am concerning the tall task we have taken up. But at the same time, I also feel confident at the clarity with which the guidance and the direction has been provided by the eminent personalities to us and also to all the other members of the Sanskriti Adhyayana Kendra and Sanskriti Foundation to understand how to take forward this. This gives us also a great impetus, considering that its importance has been rightly emphasized by all the speakers, and also gives us the confidence that we are on the right track, and that it is a necessary requirement for the times today that to rediscover ourselves and to channelize the energies towards formulation of policies both in the government sector and also working of the society at various levels to see that we stand on our own foot, we have our own roots stronger and stronger, and look towards the future. It's not that we live in the past. We want to know the past to look for the future. Without the past, we have no future. A person who does not know the history cannot think of its future. We have to consider the past, distill the wisdom, and also look at the future. It does not mean that we definitely not get the ideas, but we all strive to work basing on the directions given and also the continued support that we will be receiving from all of you. We have had one meeting with the experts already, just one round of discussions with them on this a few days ago. I am sure this impetus given by these elders today will bring in greater clarity and a thrust to direction in which you have to go. We have to remember the great clarion call given by the Rigveda people. From that time in itself, we know that we are not a closed society. Ano bhadrak katvo yantu vishvataha. So we have been thinking like this since the Rigveda times, which is the first Veda. So therefore, our minds are always open, but our feet will be stronger in our soil. With this, I request all other members to make note of the significant points made by us and start working in this direction. We are fortunate that we have started this work on a Vijayadashmi day, and all of the members have found time to participate in this. With all humility, I would like to give my pranams to all of you and all the members who have participated.